What up? It's the Trooper After Dark. Ha, that's stupid. It is after dark though, and it is Monday evening. I think it's like 6 p.m. What the hell are they doing to the wind here? They're building some shit. Oh wow, it's 6:30 p.m. All right.
They got cranes and shit out here. Who knows what they're doing? Building some shit.
That's good. It's about time, Vegas. You need to build some shit. By the way, there's a new casino in town called, I think it's called Lucky Dragon. It's like all Asian casino or whatever. I don't really know much about it. I don't exactly know where it is. I think it might be on Sahara. But I think you can get like some free play and shit if you go sign up for a card. I saw Pure Aggression Carl. I saw his video on YouTube where he went to Lucky Dragon. I think he got $8 in free play and like some kind of food comp or something. I know what you're thinking. The old wind poker room is all like closed off. They're probably building something or changing it into something. Oh, I forgot what I was saying. I know what you're thinking. Trooper, what the hell are you doing at the Wynn? I just decided to come down to this end of the strip, do something different, see things different, play in a different room. I think I'm gonna play in the Venetian. Check out these Christmas decorations at the Wynn. Christmas win. Don't you just feel like this end of the strip is in order? Don't you just feel like a nice walk? Just do something different? Spent so much time on the MGM in New York end of the strip. While since I've been over here to the fashion show mall, and there's a lot of new shit open. I see a place called Wicked Slice. I'm sure if I hadn't just eaten on the way here, I would go get pizza there. We'll definitely be trying it at some point.
Remember, I used to work right up there, Maggiano's.
I'm an idiot for eating on the way here. No way can I eat that, but that shit looks great. Really big slices. It looks like they're about, it's $5.50 for just cheese, or it's like $6.50 a slice for all kinds of shit. I'm going to the shoe store right here. What am I trying to say? Prime rib. They got one with prime rib on it. They got one with three different kinds of pepperoni. I'm looking forward to that at some point, maybe tomorrow. How you doing? Yo, I put my shoes in the kitchen sink last night because I wanted to wash them. I'm not wearing them now. I'm wearing running shoes that I wear to the gym. My other shoes, though, I don't know if them shits are gonna dry. How are you gonna have a sign that says hot donuts? Damn, you smell that?
Sorry.
They reheat the donuts in like a little toaster oven. I don't need no damn donuts. I'm just saying the shit smells good, all right?
Benihana. I've never been to a Benihana before.
I feel like I've been to like a copycat of Benihana. Is that where they cook the shit up on the grill right in front of you at the table? I've been to a bunch of those, if that's what that is. Oh, check out this coffee spot right here.
I think I've been there before. I think I like their coffee. Can't really remember for sure.
Lobster roll joint right there. What? What does that say? I can't read it. It's fucking backwards. Oh, Luke's Lobsters. When you flip the screen up on this camera, it mirrors the shit. Like the front-facing camera on a phone or something. I don't know why. Well, I guess I kind of know why, but... Oh shit, how you doing? All right. Should I offer to take a picture for him? It's awful cold out here for those short dresses. That wasn't a complaint, by the way. Gotten a hot drink of some sort, probably coffee, for the walk over here because the atmosphere is perfect for it. I don't know if you know this, but I'm a very vibe-oriented person, very mood-like vibe, or I don't know how to explain it, but that's why I like to change poker rooms so much at like casinos or whatever. But it's very difficult for me to get enough of the wintry, cold atmosphere. Here you go. The reason I didn't get a Starbucks is because there's a coffee place. I want to try their hot coffee in the canal shops here at the Venetian. So I want this painting, and that painting in my apartment. I have a feeling that I can't even afford one corner of that painting. And by the way, I would like that one as well. Mail time? No? Just kidding. I feel bad when I get a $10 Starbucks card in the mail.
Oh, we got the Palazzo entrance to the canal shops decked out for Christmas. What the hell are those deer made out of? Should we go take a closer look? Let's go take a closer look.
By the way, I know what you're thinking, Trooper. I didn't know you like art. What?
Christmas balls. No? Okay. Big ass pine cone. Somebody left their Godiva chocolate bag. There's nothing in it. Talking about some love. I don't have to go all the way over there. Here's the deer. Can't tell if that's metal or... That shit is actually wood, I think. I think it's wood that's been painted gold. I'm about to knock that bitch over.
I hope I don't knock that deer over, but if I do, or if I did, please let the camera be rolling.
In other words, say the fuck off the deer.
Tell me what those damn deer were made out of. I still think it's actual twigs. Wasn't there some kind of cartoon or something where something about a dog and something about a squirrel? Anyway, I feel like the dog in that cartoon, if that cartoon actually exists, because I got all distracted by about 12 different things on the way over here, one of which was some damn deer.
Oh, this is a new restaurant right here. Mercado something something. I can't read the shit from here, but here's where we're going. Paris Baguette. They gotta have good coffee, right? Every bit of this shit looks good to me.
Coffee's a little weak. That place nails the atmosphere, but the coffee's not that good. It really does feel like what I imagine a cafe in Paris. I've never been to Paris, though. I'm gonna tell you something right now. If I owned a coffee house, I would kill it. Absolutely kill it. Because I, better than most who go into a coffee shop or a coffee house or a cafe, know exactly what someone who goes in there wants. I actually used to work in a coffee shop in Myrtle Beach. I've mentioned that in the vlog before. And it was like a independently owned little coffee house owned by a local couple. It was coffee bar and used bookstore. I worked 6 days a week, 12 hours a day. I think maybe the sixth day I only worked 8 hours. It's a long story, but part of the time I worked in there by myself. I was usually off, I believe, on Mondays, and on Tuesdays I would get berated, friendly berated, by so many regular customers going, "Where the hell were you yesterday? My coffee wasn't right, blah, 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 blah." Because you know why? I'm gonna tell you the secret to making fantastic coffee, specifically espresso drinks. Love. You gotta put the love in it. And I know what you're thinking, Trooper. Did you say the love? Yeah, the love. All right, let's pause right here just for a second before I walk into the poker room to acknowledge something. It's important. There have been times in the past that whenever I go into Venetian Poker Room and sit down, I go on insta-tilt. Insta-tilt. And I don't usually tilt as a result of things that happen in the game. I just tilt for some reason. It's irrational, it's illogical, but tonight I'm in the mood to play here, but I'm gonna monitor my Venetian tilt very closely, and at the slightest sign of any bit of it, we're out of here. So we're off to kind of a crappy start, a little bit of an unlucky situation. I'm in the game for 710. I have about 300 on the table now, so I'm down like four. Yo, I'm running so bad. It really is incredible how I run so bad at Venetian all the time. Obviously, it's all coincidence, since there's no such thing as luck or jinxes or any of that other horseshit that people like to blame stuff on. But I just keep getting fucking murdered by the deck. It's a kind of a limpy game, and when they do raise preflop, they make it 7 or 8. But it just limped to me on the button, and I raised to 12 with king 8 of hearts. I got called by the small blind, the big blind, and the under the gun limper. So four ways. The flop was 10 high with 2 hearts. So it checks to me, and I check. Peel the free card. So the jack of hearts comes off on the turn. The small blind leads out for 20. The other two fold, and I just call 20. So the river is some sort of, oh, the river's like the jack of clubs. So he leads out for 35, and I'm like, he has a jack in his hand, and I'm about to get paid, because he has no idea that I have a flush. No clue. I mean, I raised pre-flop, and then I checked the flop behind the other three players with a flush draw? No, right? So I raised to like 140 or something like that, and he just calls with the ace 6 of hearts. So that's just incredibly unlucky. That's just like getting fucking struck by lightning, and not in a good way. So there you go. I'm fucking stuck like 600 now. Two seats to my right calls 40 with just a gut shot on the flop. That cost me the first buy-in, and then there's just like a couple of smaller hands here and there, and now that hand cost me a lot. So I'm down like 2 buy-ins right now, minus 600. I can't imagine a scenario wherein I would ever hang out in the men's room in a casino, leaning up on the fucking wall between the sinks and the urinals, text messaging. I just don't get it. Who the fuck hangs out in the restroom? And do you know how fucking dirty that wall is? You know how much piss mist is on that wall? Let alone doo-doo dust. I said it, doo-doo dust. I'm in a pretty good mood right now. And do you want to know why I'm in a good mood right now? Because I decided to quit the game at the Venetian after about 4.5 hours. And I lost 628, which is a little over 2 buy-ins. Whenever I'm at the Venetian, if I'm down in the game, I I tend to develop a really shitty attitude. Like, I was never on tilt, but my attitude is just shitty. So I think that things aren't going well tonight, so I quit. Fuck it. And this is the struggle for me. The struggle is not worrying about 628. I'm not worried about that 628. What I'm worried about is that I play at the Venetian for 4.5 hours. I develop a really shitty attitude because I'm down, and then I quit. So, like, that's just not a very productive mindset. Although I will say that playing 4.5 hours and being stuck 600 and quitting is a lot better than playing 4.5 hours being up 600 and quitting. Because had I been up, I wouldn't have a shitty attitude. And if I was up and I had a good attitude, then that would be the time to put in more hours. But in a perfect world, if I was a perfect person, then I would be able to put in a lot of hours no matter what. I like the Venetian when I'm winning. When I'm not winning, I don't like the Venetian. As far as I can tell, that's the end of the vlog today. Remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe so you don't miss anything. Tell your friends about the videos so they can watch them too. It's cold out here. I'll see you next time.